The new home assistant, drag and drop, is the next best thing since the sliced bread. Or maybe not. Let me explain. Drag and drop was probably the most requested feature in Home Assistant for years, and now it is finally here, in a form of a sections with a tile cards inside, as you'll see later. But before that, I'll list 5 important things that you have to know before start using all of these. To have access to the drag and drop, you need to update to Home Assistant 2024.3 release or higher. If you are watching this before the official release, you can get the beta version or nightly builds to test the new features that you are about to see. To get started with drag and drop, you need to create a new dashboard or new view or both. If you are a brand new Home Assistant user or you are using the default dashboard, you have to take the manual control first so you can test the drag and drop functionality. Using the default dashboard means that Home Assistant will arrange and display all of your other devices and sensors automatically for you. On the other hand, if you take control, you have to manually edit your dashboard and you can add whatever device you want in whatever cart and order you wish. This, of course, is giving you more flexibility and control, but also you have to take care of that. Fortunately, manually adding these things is quite easy and the only way, at least for now, to get drag and drop in Home Assistant. This is how I can easily create a new view in my existing dashboard. I will click on this pencil button right here, then on this plus button, I'll type a name. I can select an icon that is optional, and the most important part here is that I have to choose sections experimental here, and then I'll have to click on save button, and here it is. I can now add sections. Next thing that it is worth mentioning is that the Home Assistant drag and drop, aka sections, are not the default view for now. You have to explicitly select sections when you create a new view. That leads us to the next important thing, which is you cannot convert existing views to sections and you have to create a new one from scratch. That means your current dashboards and views are safe, at least for now. But here is how I can create a new Home Assistant dashboard and a view with the sections, aka drag and drop enabled. Inside Home Assistant, I'll press the C button to invoke this search command bar and I'll type dashboards. Then I'll select Navigate Dashboards. I will click on this Add Dashboard button, New Dashboard from scratch. I'll type a name here, drag and drop. I'll select an icon again that is entirely optional. And then I'll click on Create. And this is it. This is my new dashboard. I can click again on the pencil button and I cannot change the home view from masonry to sections. That's why I'll have to create a new view here. And again, I have to type a title. I can select an icon and so on and so forth. And this time sections is enabled. I can select it and I'll click save. If I wish, I can now delete the home view because I want only the drag and drop view to be available. I'll click on the pencil button next to the home view and then I'll click on delete view. Delete again, and now I'll have only one view in this dashboard. And this is where the fun begins. Before we go to the fun part, namely dragging and dropping some stuff around, you can download my smart home glossary, which is full of simple yet useful explanations of the most common smart home terms and acronyms. This glossary is actually one big PDF file and it is all free. One more thing that it is good to know before we start is that Home Assistant sections are in an experimental state. That means the things you are about to see now may receive some changes in the future releases. And how big those changes will be, I don't know. The main idea is that the sections view to become the default one for Home Assistant, but only after everything is smooth as butter. And that is why there is an experimental label. With that being said, let's start an experiment with the experimental sections. And this is one empty view with one unnamed section. I can name it however I wish. And here I have two placeholders. From this placeholder right here, I can add a cart. I'll see the familiar dialog. for adding cards that we have in the previous releases, and from here I can select anything I wish to add, or I can go to the By Entity tab and I can select my stuff here, and I'll click continue, and this is how the new card will look like, and I can add it to dashboard. I can now drag and drop these entities inside the card without any issue, and I can add another section. This section will be again named with some very original name, demo 2, and I'll add another entities here, like that, add to dashboard. I can add one more section, it is not a problem at all. It will be named demo 3, and again I can add something inside. Now I can move the sections however I wish, for example like that. I can also copy these and I can paste it right here. As you can see, I can paste from clipboard and I can click save, and this entity right here is now copied from demo 2 to demo 1. I can also cut this and I can paste it here the same way. Or if I want faster cut and paste, I can drag and drop this card right here and I can put it. That way it will be moved from demo 3 to demo 1 section with a click of a button. How cool is that? I can also duplicate cards. I can also enable features if they support such things. And everything is possible basically. Currently you can see that this device is now duplicated. I'll also add one more section. This section will be called map, and I'll add the map card. I'll enter the required entities in order this map to work, and I want to show you the following. I can enable different aspect ratio here, for example 16:9, and I can click save, and this is my map card in an aspect ratio 19:6. I can edit it, I can switch this 9:16, and this will be changed in a vertical mode, and I can resize it that way. I can also try to resize my browser and everything will stay visible and nicely arranged. Like that. Good one. I can add a vertical stack, for example, and I can select entities and they will be ordered in a vertical way. Of course, I can delete sections by clicking on the garbage button. And when I'm ready, I can click on done. And this is my new drag and drop view, or sections view, in Home Assistant. Now, what's next? The worst case scenario is that nobody to like this new drag and drop, aka sections view, and all this effort to be thrown in the garbage, in a favor of the good old masonry view. But that is highly unlikely, don't you think? Please, share your thoughts in the comments below. I'm interested to see your opinion here. Thanks for watching, I'm Kiryu, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!